Hi everyone, I am sitting here with some cut out fabrics and garments in various stages of completion because this year I am making only handmade garments for my immediate family, which spurred this idea to make a video about my thoughts when it comes to sewing for others. So that's what we're going to talk about today. And I think a lot of us home sewers has what I would say rather conflicted emotions when it comes to sewing for others. And it can definitely be a topic I think is really interesting to discuss. I'm super curious about your thoughts about this. So I will just address some of the things that I think is important for me personally and also perhaps can help you make a decision if you want to make something for others or not. Because sometimes we get asked and we're not really sure how to say yes or no. And the first thing I think is really important to think about is this a person that we really want to sew something for? That I think is one of the most important criteria actually, because if it's very different for me if a friend, a close friend, or my daughters or my husband ask for something, because I feel a very strong emotional bond to those people and they are the persons that I love to make something for and show my appreciation and give them my gift of a handmade things. Whereas if a work colleague would ask me the same thing, I have no emotional attachment to that person in a way that I have, say, with a close friend, which is something makes a big difference for me if in the decision process, if this is a person I want to make something for or not. And for the most part, what my main sort of projects that I've done for others has been, you know, the closest family and friends. I think there's only one exception to that, which was when I made a bridal dress for a works friend sister. And the reason why I did that is actually another point that I think is important to consider, and that is, will I learn something from this project? Is this a project that will actually give me something in return? And I had not made a constructed dress before I did this wedding dress for her, and this was a very intricate project with boning, you know, proper corset making. It had lace, it involved lots of hand sewing, and of course the fit had to be exact because this was a really fitted dress. So even though it was definitely something that I had to stretch my skills, I really enjoyed the project because it was a very interesting learning experience for me, and I actually enjoy hand sewing a lot. So a lot of these parts were actually quite enjoyable, and being able to see the finished garment, and it actually felt surreal that I had managed to pull that dress off because it was really, really intricate. And that brings me to another point, because that's also one of the things that are really important if you want to make clothes for other people, is that they are very good at communicating what they want, because it's so easy to fall into the trap of trying to interpret what the other person's vision is, and that is usually where it goes wrong. And I've seen a lot of examples if you watch the series Project Runway, for instance, when they do commission works in some of the episodes, there's usually a lot of really serious miscommunication going on between the person who's ordering the garment and the designer, and that I think is very, very important to be clear about. So if you want to make something for another, it's really important, I think, that person says that this is what I am looking for, and this is how I want it to fit, this is the sort of fabrics I want to use. If they have inspiration pictures, it makes it so much easier, and even better if they already have a garment that is very similar. That can also help guide us through the process of actually constructing a garment that will fit and look the way they had envisioned in their head. So I think it's really important to have a very specific communication and not trying to do the guesswork, because I feel that is something that can usually end up being quite wrong. So for instance, I've made this top for my oldest daughter. This is a wool top that she can wear because she's actually this winter is going to work as a skiing teacher. So I really wanted to make something for her to have when she's doing her new very exciting job, and also something where I can express my own creativity. Now of course this is a little bit of guesswork because she has an idea of what she wants this type of sweater to look like, and I might have a different idea. So what I asked her is that, please, if you have anything similar that you like the fit of, can you borrow that to me so I can measure everything? So she gave me this sweater, which is a ready-to-wear sweater, also a wool sweater, and because I was able to measure all the things and see that this is a good fit for her, I was able to translate that into the sweater that I made for her. So we have already sorted that the fit will be alright, and the design, I obviously made some my own. She hasn't seen the fabric or the detailing or anything like that, and I also did take some creative freedom because I noticed that the sleeves are very long, because just like me, my daughters are fairly short, so the sleeves are really, really long, so I actually shortened them a bit, so I hope she don't mind that, because I felt that they could actually benefit from being a bit shorter. So that's just one example, and also I'm making a loungewear sweater and trouser set for my youngest daughter. And again, she's been involved in the process, she's actually picked the fabric. So again, not 100% surprised, but as I said, there's a reason for that. So this is the fabric that I'm using for the sweater. And again, I asked her to show me some of the garments that she really liked the fit of. So for instance, she has bought this absolutely amazing vintage sweatshirt. So this is what I've used as the base for the pattern that I've used for the sweater. So it's actually will be quite similar in the fit, which I think is so important, because that means that I will not try to make any guesswork, because she has shown me this is the sort of style I like, this is sort of fit I like. So there's no risk that I will make my own interpretations of what I find being the right fit. For instance, I like my clothes more fitted than my youngest daughter, who's more into like a baggy street style look. So again, very, very important, if they have a well-fitting garment they can show you, that will make the work so much easier. And to go back to the example of the bridal dress that I made, and I also made the graduation dress for my oldest daughter this year, which again was a very fitted, constructed style using a very fine fabric, and that is, it's so important to do fittings. I always, when I do something for another person that involves a fitted style, I always do a sample garment first using, you know, regular muslin, you know, unbleached cotton or whatever, just to make sure that the fit is fine. So I definitely do several test rounds on that person before I sew all the seams together, just to make sure that the fit is on point, because we all have our ideas and we know our bodies quite well, but it's absolutely impossible to guess that. So, but when we put a test garment on the person and see how it looks in real life, that just makes everything so much easier, wouldn't you agree? So definitely take time to do fittings, and don't just start and finish and without having that sort of check-in process, which I think is so important when you're doing clothes for other people. Another point that I think is really important, and something I also thought about a lot when I'm watching Project Runway, is that you need to trust your competence. Even though it's really important to have a dialogue with the person you're making garments for, you also need to be assured in your own sewing skills and your own ideas on what makes a best construction process and all the things like that. So I think when you're doing for others, it's very easy to sort of start second-guessing ourselves and perhaps doubt our sewing skills, and maybe feel more aware of all the little tiny things that doesn't, you know, look as perfect as we would want them to. But it's really important also to remember that people who don't sew often are absolutely blown away by the fact that we can actually make a garment using our, you know, our own skills without any formal training for the most of the time. And we shouldn't be hard on ourselves when it comes to that, because we have lots of skills that most people have no idea on how to replicate. So that's really important. And also, as I said, to give advice, and perhaps sometimes we know better than the customer when it comes to certain things. So it definitely needs to be a dialogue that goes both ways when you're discussing, you know, certain details of the garment and stuff like that. So definitely stand up for your competence, and when there is actually an issue where you know you're right, you need to stand firm in that as well. So definitely give a take, and I think, in the design process. The last advice that I want to give is this a project that will revitalize yourself or give you a sewing burnout? I definitely think that this is a point where we should definitely listen to our gut feeling. Because, you know, sometimes when we get asked things and we hear ourselves saying yes, and then we can feel a little knot in the stomach and like, oh, what did I do? Why did I say yes to that? Because I don't really want to do it. I think that's so important because we know that sewing takes so much time. It can take days, weeks, sometimes even months spending on a particular garment. So I definitely don't want you to end up in a situation where you say yes to something and then you will just makes you feel really yucky about the sewing process. So definitely, I think this is an area where you should definitely listen to your gut feeling and see if it's something that energizes you or just makes you go, oh, I don't really want to do that. So these were my thoughts about when it comes to sewing for others. I'm really curious about your thoughts as well, because I think there are a lot of different aspects to consider when you say yes, or for instance, in this case, I'm actually doing something that is not even asked for in some of the cases, but it's something that I want to make for my loved ones. So there are lots of different things to consider. And also, I'm sure that some of you have a very staunch approach that I don't sew for anyone except myself, which I can totally understand and respect. That's probably a bit of my leaning as well. But I've definitely made quite a few clothes to other people as well during the year. So I'd love to hear your thoughts about that. And if you haven't already, please subscribe for weekly sewing videos. Stitch safe, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.